A very warm welcome to all of you. Today is our discussion topic is current source inverter. In voltage source inverters, the input voltage is maintained constant and the amplitude of output voltage does not depend upon the nature of the load. But in the waveform of load current, its magnitude depends upon the nature of the load impedance. In current source inverters, the input current is constant but it is adjustable. The amplitude of output current is independent of the nature of the load, but the magnitude of output voltage depends upon the nature of the load impedance. In current source inverter, the DC input current is converted into AC output current, and the frequency of this AC output current depends upon the rate of triggering of the SCRs. The amplitude of AC output current can be adjusted by controlling the magnitude of DC input current. Okay, the current source inverter does not require any feedback diode as in case of voltage source inverters. The commutation circuit used in current source inverter is very simple as it consists of only the commutating capacitor. Okay, now we are going to see the working of single phase capacitor commutated current source inverter with resistive load. Figure shows the circuit diagram of the single phase CSI with resistive load. It consists of a constant and adjustable DC current source. The capacitor C is connected in parallel with the resistance R, which is used for storing the charge for force commutation of the SCRs. The thyristor T1 and T2 are triggered simultaneously by using the gate pulses IG1 and IG2. In the same way, the thyristors T3 and T4 are triggered simultaneously by using the triggering pulses IG3 and IG4. Okay. Here we will see the working of the circuit at various instants. Okay, the figure here shows the various waveforms, across the capacitor, the current flowing through the capacitor, the output voltage, output current, input voltage, the voltage across thyristor VT1 and VT2 and so on. Okay, before the time instant T is equivalent to 0, the conducting thyristors are T3 and T4. Okay, the capacitor is initially, the capacitor is considered as the charge across the capacitor is equivalent to minus V1. Okay, with left plate negative and the right plate positive. When T1 and T2 are gated at T is equivalent to 0, the capacitor voltage VC reverse biases the conducting thyristor T3 and T4. So, the T3 and T4 gets commutated instantly. Okay, when the thyristor T1 and T2 gets turned on, the current flows through the thyristor T1, then the parallel combination of R and C, and then through the T2. Okay, now from 0 to T/2, IT1 and IT2 is considered as magnitude is equivalent to I. The output current IAC is equivalent to I now. The capacitor voltage now changes from minus V1 to plus V1, the capacitor current IC flows through the capacitor. Okay, now here the load voltage is equivalent to the capacitor voltage as load is connected in parallel with the C. So Vout is equivalent to VC. Okay, so as capacitor voltage changes, the output voltage also changes from minus V1 towards the plus V1. Okay. Now the current waveform is equivalent to, so as I0 is equivalent to V0 divided by R, which is equivalent to VC divided by R, okay, the output current waveform follows the output, or it is in phase with the output voltage. So it has the similar waveforms. Okay, the magnitude of the output current is minus I1 at T is equivalent to 0, and it goes on changing towards the plus I1 at T is equivalent to T/2 here. Okay, when T3 and T4 are triggered at the instant T/2 here. Okay, so the capacitor voltage is now V1, which reverse biases the thyristors T1 and T2 so that they get turned off immediately. Okay, now T3 and T4 are conducting. Okay, so IT3 and IT4 is equivalent to I now, but the current is flowing, from the current source through T3, okay, through the parallel combination of R and C through T4. Okay, now the current direction is opposite as that of the previous case. So AC is equivalent to minus I now. Okay, so at T is equivalent to 0, the capacitor charge is equivalent to minus V1. Okay, so that it is equivalent to the output voltage, which is equal to minus V1. The load current has the magnitude is equivalent to minus I1. Okay, now from T is equivalent to 0 to T by 2, the capacitor charges from minus V1 to plus V1. Okay, so that at the instant T is equivalent to T by 2, I0 has the magnitude is equivalent to I1. Okay, the input voltage V in is equivalent to V out. Okay, from the instant T is equivalent to 0 to T by 2. Okay, so V in is equivalent to minus V1 here. V in is equal to minus V1 and it goes on changing as per the it goes on changing towards the plus V at this instant. Okay, at the instant T by 2, here the input voltage becomes equivalent to minus V out. Okay, so it is equivalent to minus V. Okay, at this instant V out is equivalent to, sorry, V in is equivalent to minus V out. So it will become equivalent to minus V1 and again it goes on changing towards the it will go towards the plus V1. Now when T1 and T2 are conducting from 0 to, by observing this equivalent circuit during the time interval 0 to T by 2 here, okay, we can observe that, okay, when the thyristor T1 and T2 are conducting, okay, for the time interval 0 to T by 2, the current IC and I0 are leaving the terminal A, okay, while the current I is entering into the terminal A. Okay, so that we can write by applying KCL, we can write it here as I0 plus IC is equivalent to I. So IC becomes equivalent to I minus I0. Okay, now at the instant T is equivalent to 0. Okay, we can see here at the instant T is equivalent to 0. The output current has the magnitude is equal to minus I1. So here I0 is equivalent to minus I1. Replacing this value, we have IC is equivalent to I minus of minus I1, which is equal to I plus I1. Okay. In the same manner, at the instant T is equivalent to T by 2. Okay, I0 is equivalent to plus I1. So replacing this value, we have the capacitor current is equal to I minus of I1 is equal to I minus I1. Observe here, capacitor current at instant T is equivalent to 0, it is I plus I1, and at instant T is equivalent to T by 2, it is I minus I1. Okay, now from the at the instant T by 2, now the thyristor T3 and T4 gets turned on while the thyristor T1 and T2 are commutated. Okay, so just before T by 2 here, by observing the equivalent circuit during the time interval T by 2 to T here, okay, at the node B, the current IC and I0 are entering into the node. Okay, while all the three currents are entering into the node B. Okay, so that the equivalent equation is, or the KCL, by applying KCL, the equation is I0 plus IC plus I is equivalent to 0. Okay, so at the instant T is equivalent to T by 2, I0 is equivalent to I1. Okay, replacing this value in the equation of IC, IC is now equivalent to minus I minus I0. Okay, so replace the value of I0 here. So IC becomes equal to minus I minus I1. Okay, which is equal to minus I of I plus I1. Minus of I plus I1. Okay, at the instant T is equivalent to T, okay, the I0 has the magnitude is equivalent to minus I1. So I0 is equivalent to minus I1 here. IC becomes equal to minus I plus I1 which is equal to minus of I minus I1. Okay, so observe the capacitor current here. At the instant t by 2, it gets to, or it becomes equal to minus I plus I1. Okay, and here minus of I minus I1 at the instant t is equivalent to t here. Okay, the voltage across the thyristor T1 is equivalent to 0 when they are conducting. Okay, so T1, VT1 and VT2 is equivalent to 0 during the instant 0 to T by 2. Okay, now as here these thyristors T1 and T2 gets turned off, the voltage will become equivalent to the input voltage, and at this instant the input voltage is equal to minus V1, okay, which is equal to the capacitor voltage. So it appears across the thyristor, okay, and it follows the input voltage now. So input voltage changes from minus V1 to plus V1. So out, here the thyristor voltage also changes from minus V1 to plus V1, and so on. Okay, so here again, so this is VT1 and VT2. Okay, in the same way we can find out the waveform for VT2, VT3 and VT4 when they are conducting. Okay, so these are nothing but the waveform analysis of the current source inverter. Okay, now from the interval, for the interval 0 to T by 2 here, the capacitor is initially, we know that the capacitor is initially charged to a voltage minus V1. Okay, so initially the capacitor voltage is equivalent to minus V1. Okay, now here in the circuit, okay, by applying or by considering the closed path A, B, C, D and A, here we can write R into I0 minus 1 upon C integral of capacitor current, which is I minus I0 dt plus V1 is equal to 0. Okay, this is for the time interval 0 to T by 2. Okay, so we know that the capacitor current is I minus I0. So here we have replaced the capacitor current value. Okay, now differentiate this with respect to T. Okay, by differentiating this equation with respect to T, we have R into dI by dt plus I naught divided by C into I divided by IC. We will consider this as equation number 1. Consider this as equation number 2. Okay. So here we can write R into P plus 1 upon C the whole multiplied by I naught is equal to I by C. We will consider this as equation number 3. Okay. The complementary function of the solution is obtained, the complementary function of the solution is obtained by the force-free solution. Okay, the force-free solution is given by Rp plus 1 upon C into ICP is equivalent to 0. We'll consider this as equation number 4. Okay, so that here Rp plus 1 upon C becomes equal to 0. And so that P becomes equal to 1 upon minus 1 divided by RC. Okay, we will consider this as equation number 5. Okay. Okay, now as the force free equation ICP is equivalent to A into e raised to TP. Okay, here ICP becomes A into e raised to minus t divided by RC. Okay, we will consider this as equation number 6. Under the steady state condition, the load current at t is equivalent to 0. Okay, here I naught is equivalent to minus I1. Okay, so minus I1 is equivalent to I plus A. Okay, where A becomes equivalent to minus I minus I1. Okay, so I naught becomes equivalent to I minus I plus I1 into e raised to minus t divided by RC. Okay, So here I naught is equal to okay I into 1 minus e raised to minus t divided by RC minus I1 into e raised to minus t divided by RC. Okay, so this is our equation number 9. Okay, for the time interval 0 to t by 2. Okay, so as only steady state solution is desired, the current I0 at t is equivalent to t by 2 becomes I1. Okay, so here I naught becomes equivalent to I1 at the instant t is equivalent to t by 2. Okay, so replacing this value in the equation number 9, we have I1 is equivalent to I into 1 minus e raised to minus t divided by RC, okay, minus I1 into e raised to minus t by 2 RC as t is equivalent to t by 2. Okay, replacing this value in the equation, we have I1 into e raised to minus t divided by 2 RC. Okay, by solving this, we have I1 is equal to I multiplied by 1 minus e raised to minus t by 2 RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 RC. Okay, so here if the value of t by 2 times RC is very very greater than 1, then here I1 will become equivalent to I. This total term becomes equivalent to 1. So I1 will become equivalent to I at this condition. Okay, substituting these values in equation number 9, we have, okay, we have to replace the value of I1 in equation number 9. So we have I0 is equivalent to I into 1 minus e raised to minus t divided by RC minus I into 1 minus e raised to minus t divided by 2 RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 RC multiplied by e raised to minus t divided by RC. Okay, so solving this, we have I naught is equal to I multiplied by 1 minus e raised to minus t divided by RC minus 1 minus e raised to minus 2 divided by 2 times RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 times RC multiplied by e raised to minus t divided by RC. Okay, so simplifying it further, we have I naught is equivalent to I multiplied by 1 minus 2 times e raised to minus t divided by RC, the whole divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t by 2 RC. Okay, this is the equation for our output current. Okay, now the output voltage V out is equivalent to VC and it is equivalent to R into I naught. So V out becomes equal to R into I multiplied by 1 minus 2 times e raised to minus t divided by RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 RC. When t is equivalent to tc, okay, so here when t is equivalent to tc here at this instant, okay, the output voltage is equivalent to 0. Okay, so V out is equivalent to VC, which is equivalent to R into I multiplied by 1 minus 2 e raised to minus t divided by RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 times RC becomes equal to 0 at the instant t is equivalent to TC. Okay, so solving this, we have 1 minus 2 times e raised to minus t divided by RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 times RC is equal to 0. Okay, so 2 times e raised to minus t divided by RC becomes equal to 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 times RC. Okay, so further simplifying this, becomes equivalent to 1 half into 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 times rc. Okay. Now, by taking natural logarithm on both the sides, we have minus tc divided by rc is equal to ln of 1 half into 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by 2 times rc. Okay. So, minus tc is equal to rc into this whole term. Okay. So, tc becomes equal to rc into ln of 2 divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by rc. Okay. So, tc equal to rc into ln of 2 divided by 1 plus e raised to minus t divided by rc. Okay. This is the time interval at which the input voltage becomes equal to 0. Okay. Now, the average value of input voltage is given as V in is equal to 1 divided by T by 2 integral from 0 to T by 2 to I naught into R is multiplied by or dt. So, it is equal to 2 times R divided by T integral from 0 to T by 2 I naught of dt. Replacing the value of I naught, we have V in is equal to 2R by T integral from 0 to T by 2 I into 1 minus 2 times e raised to minus T divided by RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus T divided by 2 times RC dt. Okay. By solving this interval, we have V in is equal to I into R multiplied by 1 minus 4 times RC divided by T into 1 minus e raised to minus T divided by 2 times RC divided by 1 plus e raised to minus T divided by 2 times RC. Okay, so this is our equation for input voltage. Okay, when input power V in into I is positive, the power is delivered to the loop. Okay, so this is all about the current source inverters. Thank you.